إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن شاء الله we are coming end of Ramadan, and at the end of Ramadan there is two other wujubis we should perform. Number one, Zakat al-Fitr, and number two, Salat al-Eid. They required us to fulfill that two duties. So inshallah we will see Zakat al-Fitr, and we will ask some questions for clarification, and we answer that question through our lecture. So Zakat al-Fitr, the first question, لماذا نؤدي زكاة الفطر? Why we should pay زكاة الفطر? What's the reason to pay it? That's the first question. The second question, على من تجب زكاة الفطر? زكاة الفطر is compulsory upon who? Who should pay the زكاة الفطر? Number three, لمن تجب زكاة الفطر? Whom should receive the Zakat al-Fitr? So you are one of two. Either you will pay Zakat al-Fitr or you will receive Zakat al-Fitr. You can't be in between. So in which group you are in? You should know your rights and the duties upon you. Number three, وقت إخراجها. What time you should give Zakat al-Fitr? ونوعها, what type we should give. ومقدارها, which amount. It doesn't mean you will give when you want. It doesn't mean you will give what you want. It doesn't mean you will give how much you want. There's limits. You can't be less than that limit. So that question is, will fulfill our lecture inshallah. Is Zakat al-Fitr compulsory? Is it Farad Zakat al-Fitr? Yeah. Or it is Sunnah? You can do anywhere, anytime. Yeah. That's the main question. Zakat al-Fitr, is it compulsory wajib upon you? Or is it Sunnah? It's on your choice. You pay when you want. Everything we say, inshallah, it's with evidence. We don't say from our own view. In Sahih Abi Dawood, عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال, فرض رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زكاة الفطر. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم made compulsory upon us زكاة الفطر. To pay what? Why you are paying? طهرة للصائم. Purifies our fast. من اللغو والرفث. اللغو means the words or the talk which have not any benefit. والرفث means something you can get sin if you do it. So you can make mistake while you are, all day you are fasting, and especially when you are hungry and you lose your temper and you are a bit upset, and you answer to others some rough answers, it can affect you Ramadan. Yeah. So it can purify your fasting. That's number one. وَضُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينِ is provision, food for the miskins. Yeah. On the old days, that was the Prophet ﷺ, there were no third party between you and the miskin. There were no third party between you and the miskin. So for man addaha, whoever gives to the miskin, قبل الصلاة, before he breaks his salah, فهي زكاة مقبولة, it's acceptable زكاة. ومن أداها بعد الصلاة, whoever gives to the miskin after salah, فهي صدقة من الصدقات, it will be صدقة, not زكاة. I still require it from you, you زكاة. And you can't turn the time backwards to pay the zakah. So you should pay to the miskin. If the miskin is somewhere else far, your representative should pray to the miskin before you pray yourself. A lot of us, we see, we come to the masjid, we put in the box. So in that case, masjid our representative. But did you give much time to pray? No. You put your zakah in the box, and immediately you are starting your salah. So it's not going to be zakah for you. You can't put the fault on the masjid in that case. You have to send it a bit earlier to someone who can buy the food and give to the miskin food. Masjid, they can accept the cash, not food. But what they can do with the cash when you pay it a minute or two before you pray your salah. They can't pay food and give to the miskin. So be careful when you are paying to your zakat. Don't pay to the masjids in the UK. They don't have that limitation to pay it in the same day. Yeah. If you don't have miskin, send it to your representative back home, and he will buy food, and he will give to the miskin. So if your zakat reaches to the miskin before you pray, it is zakat for you. If it reaches to the miskin after you pray, it is salah, not zakat. In that case, when you are sending your zakah, number one, your aqiqah, number two, your zakatul mal, number three, you want to send it to someone who knows the ruling of that. You send it to someone who is jahil to be your representative, how you can serve you wrongly. So you are accountable for that. You are accountable for that. حديث متفق عليه عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنه قال فرض رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زكاة الفطر ساعا من تمر one ساعة of cakes أو ساعا من شعير or one ساعة of barley. So in the ساعة is certain amount, certain size. That size, whatever you put in there, the weight is different. If you put in there cakes, cakes have stones, there are more weight. If you put in there rice or barley, it's less weight than. That's why it's called restrictive boundary for the weight. But the size is one size. That size, that is the size of the Prophet, one size. Yeah. But the weight in there can be different. You pay that alal abdi, it's upon the slave to pay. Wal hurri and the free person. Wal dhakari wal untha, upon the male and female. Wal saghiri wal kabiri, and the young ones and old ones, min al muslimin among Muslims. So who is paying zakah? Whoever have his food that day, it's compulsory for him to pay zakah. It's not a week or month, that day. If you have that day, you risk. That means you are rich. People don't see that way. To be rich, they want to look to how much in the account. But there's no limit that. That's no limit. So the ghina in the Islam, when you are health that day, and you are in peace, and you have your provision that day, you are rich, you are the best one in the world. We don't look to this way. Yeah. You need more and more and more and more until you go to the career. So if you have your risk one day, that means it's on you to pay the zakah. وَأَمَرَ بِهَا أَنْ تُؤَدَّى رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ to pay the zakah قَبْلَ خُرُوجِ النَّاسِ إِلَى السَّلَاةِ before the people go to the salah. You pay, and miskin will receive. Yeah. And miskin, that's the condition. If you pay and it doesn't reach the miskin, it's not zakah. So be careful when you are paying your zakah. حديث متفق عليه عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه قال كنا نخرج في عهد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم الفطر. On the day of يوم الفطر at the time of Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم we used to pay ساعة من طعام وساعة food. There's no record at all Prophet paid cash or companions paid cash to the miskin. In UK, you don't have to buy food. You can send the money, the cash, to someone else, and that person should buy the food and give to the miskin. But to send the cash to the miskin, that's not allowed. That's not zakat. We'll see, inshallah. قال أبو سعيد وكان دعامنا وكان دعامنا الشعير وكان الشعير دعامنا والزبيب والأقد والتمر. This type was our food. What it means is when he say وَكَانَ دَعَامَنَا means the food of that society should be zakat al-fitr. Someone live in a rural area. He didn't see chocolate in his life. You give him chocolate, what he does with it? He's in a rural area, he doesn't see fish in his life. You give him fish in his zakat al-fitr, what's he doing with it? So the community, what they eat, that's your zakat al-fitr. Because that person, you want that person to eat. If you give him something, he doesn't know. That's not it. Zakat al-fitr is qutul baladi, the provision used in that society. If the society is in island, there's no livestock. The only thing they eat is a fish. Fish breakfast, fish dinner, fish lunch, fish. Yeah. You can't give them meat because they don't know meat. So it means qutul yawm. So the food they have that time, companions, they used to pay zakat from that food. صحيح أبي داود عن نافع عن ابن عمر قال أمرنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بزكاة الفطر أن تؤدى قبل خروج الناس إلى الصلاة to give to the مسكين before we go to the صلاة. قال فكان ابن عمر wants to be on safe side. If he comes to the صلاة and he doesn't find مسكين on that spot and Salah is going to be Iqam, he'll be in problem. So what he used to do, فَكَانَ ابْنُ عُمَرْ يُؤَدِّيهَا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ بِيَوْمٍ أَوْ يَوْمَيْنِ, that's a day or two. A day or two. So 28th, 29th of the month, you can give to the miskin. قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ بِيَوْمٍ أَوْ يَوْمَيْنِ, to be on the safe side. الموضع النافع كان ابن عمر لا يخرج إلا التمر في زكاة الفطر. He used to pay dates to the مسكين on زكاة الفطر. إلا مرة واحدة, only one time, فإنه أخرج شعيرا, he paid it in Bali. So why he selected dates? The مسكين, maybe you had iftar last night, you had dinner, but he didn't eat anything, that miskin. He came in the morning, Salah, he didn't eat anything. So Abdullah ibn Umar, he preferred to give them dates so they can eat on that time, and with full belly they can go to the Salah. That was his idea. But all that, what has been mentioned by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, is allowed to use. Scholars view, what's the value of Zakat al-Fitr? In here, Imam Nawawi said in Majmu' وعن وكيع بن جراح رحمه الله وكيع بن جراح ويس الشيخ أوف إمام شافعي الشيخ أوف إمام شافعي he is comparing زكاة الفطر to سجود السهو you pray your salah there is some deficiency in your salah you forgot something you make mistake in something what do you do in the salah you see what's the value of sujood sahwi in the salah to complete your salah So you want to compare zakat al-fitr to sujood sahwi. So he said, zakat al-fitr li shahr Ramadan. If you compare zakat al-fitr of month of Ramadan, kasajatay sahwi is similar to the two sujood of sahwi. Lissalat for the salah. تجبر نقصان الصوم in compensate it fulfills any deficiency in your fasting كما يجبر السجود نقصان الصلاة as the سجود السهوي compensate any deficiency or any miss points in your salah so that is very important that إخراج زكاة الفطر نقدا to give cash to the مسكين as زكاة الفطر scholars have three views we go through three and then we see which one is going to be overweight القول الأول أنه لا يجوز إخراجها نقدا it's not allowed you to pay cash at all to the مسكين doesn't mean you pay from your side, but it doesn't that allow you to give to the miskin cash at all in Zakat al-Fitr. وهو مذهب مالكية والشافعية وحنابلة. القول الثاني أنه يجوز إخراجها نقدا you can pay cash وهو مذهب الحنفية. القول الثالث أنه يجوز إخراجها نقدا إذا اقتضى ذلك حاجة أو مصلحة. If there is some necessity. Some necessity. Yeah. You can pay it. اختار الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية. If you can't give him food, yeah. necessity, you can give him cash. But that's not, that's view of some scholars, including ابن تيمية. Yeah. Ahmed bin Hanbal has been asked. Yeah. أبو داود said, قيل لأحمد وأنا أسمع يعدى دراهم قال أخاف أن يجزئه. I worry that it will not be sufficient for him as a zakat al-fitr. خلاف سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's opposite the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Uthaymeen, he said, zakat al-fitr لا تجوز إلا من طعام It's not acceptable from you unless it's food. ولا يجوز إخراجها من القيمة. It's not allowed to pay cash the value of the food as a cash. ولا من اللباس you can't give the person as a clothing ولا من الفرش you can't give him as a mattress in زكاة الفطر ولا أن يبنى بها مساكين الفقراء if you can't build house for the فقير person from زكاة الفطر problem here this organization is Islam, this and Islam, this and Islam, this collecting money. They take zakat al-fitr, they take aqiqah, they take zakat al-mal, they mix it all. You are not sure your zakat al-fitr has been given to miskin for food. You are not sure. That's the problem of this. They want to give something good, but they don't know the ruling behind it. All these areas of the war, They depend on them. Give them sadaqah. Give them zakat al-mal. But be careful when you're giving them the other points. بل يجب أن تخرج مما فرضه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من طعام. You should be given to a miskin what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم make it compulsory for us to pay from food. Nothing else. In here, I don't timetable. إيستان تيبل. الرقم داس كسي نمبر سيريا نمبر. العلماء scholars ماذا نتوع what they should be or will be. Number one of the scholars is الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. What he said, الطعام food to the مسكين. And then three companions fellow with him. أبو سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه, he said food. عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما, he said food. عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما, he said food. Imam Malik, he said food. Imam Waqi', Sheikh of Imam Shafi'i, he said food. Imam Shafi'i, he said food. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, he said food. Imam Nawawi, he said food. Albani, he said food. Uthaymeen, he said food. 11. On top of the 11, who? Mursal Hassan. Look at other scholars. Hassan al-Basri al-Tabi'i, he said cash. Abu Hanifa, he said cash. Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz, he said cash. Imam Sufyan al-Thawri, he said cash. This A'imma, Ishaq al-Rahwaya, he said cash at a necessity. Abu Thawr, he said cash at a necessity. Mutami, he said cash at a necessity. That's the difference in the cash. So in that difference, if you look to here, the Prophet ﷺ and three companions, they said food. Okay, so that is the miskin should receive food, not cash. The last point, when it is compulsory. When it is compulsory. When it's compulsory. This is after two times. For example, Salah. Now you can pray your Asr. Salah. But what's the best time to pray Asr? At the beginning. After Salat, if you are in the Jama'ah. But to delay, it's allowed, but it's not the Sunnah to delay it at that time. So in here, to pay Zakat al-Fitr, this attack is compulsory on you to pay, and time is allowed for you to extend. But that like, extension is coming at the beginning, not at the end. So what will you be? Yeah. They ask Uthaymeen, can we pay Zakat al-Fitr to the miskin in the first 10 days of Ramadan? If you keep your Zakat in your pocket until you give Eid, or if you send it now to the representative and he keep all the with him, same, no difference. But we are talking to give to the miskin. Can I give Zakat al-Fitr to the miskin at the first 10 days of Ramadan? Yeah, no, not a Jew. يجوز أن تقدم قبل العيد بيوم أو يومين. It's allowed for you to pay before Eid a day or two. لما في ذلك من التوسعة على المعدي والآخر. Yeah. Because this is sufficient time for both of them. أما ما قبل ذلك. To pay before that time. فالراجح من أقوال أهل العلم the overweighted view of the scholars. لا يجوز صلاه. وعلى هذا فلها وقتان. There's two times for Zakat al-Fitr. وقت الجواز, the time it's permissible for you to pay. ووقت الفضيلة, the time it is more wajib on you to pay. وقت الجواز is going to be قبل العيد بيوم أو يومين is permissible. وقت الفضيلة, the best time you pay, وهو يوم العيد قبل الصلاة. يوم العيد قبل الصلاة. Yeah. So that's two times. End of the day, it is, you have to do one of that two times, to fulfill the requirements. Amma ta'khiraha ila ma ba'd salah. To delay until after the salah, to give the miskin, فإنه حرام ولا تجزي عن الفطر. It's not fulfilling your zakat al-fitr. So it's your own responsibility to know how you deal with your zakat al-fitr. In here, few technical points. Zakat al-fitr is going to be compulsory on the Maghrib time of Eid night. Today we are fasting. Today is the last day of Ramadan. At the Maghrib time, it's new day. And that Maghrib time is going to be wajib. So whoever is alive, yeah, that Maghrib time, zakat is compulsory upon him. Yeah. So if the person dies before Maghrib, zakat is compulsory upon him. If the person born after Maghrib, zakat is compulsory upon him. If you get married and nikah happened before Maghrib, your wife is compulsory upon you to pay zakat. If whatever preparation you does, you done, the nikah happened after Maghrib, it's not compulsory upon you to pay zakat. If the person accepted Islam before sunset, compulsory for him to pay zakat. If you accept the Islam after sunset, it's not compulsory upon him to pay zakat. So the fine line is zakat al-fitr, is salat adhan of Maghrib. So in here Uthaymin said, إِذَا غَابَتِ الشَّمْسِ مِنْ لَيْلَةِ الْعِيدِ وَجَّبَتْ. The wujub is coming from one when the sun sets on the day night of Eid. So in here, فَلَا وُلُدَ لِلْإِنسَانِ وَلَدٌ. If a person, yeah, born, بعد مغيب الشمس. After sunset, yeah, ليلة العيد. لم تلزمه فترته وإنها تستحب. Yeah. It's good to pay, but it's not compulsory. ولو مات إنسان قبل غروب الشمس. The person dies before sunset, then the fitrah is not wajib upon him to pay fitr, because he didn't reach the time of the wajib, which is adhan or sunset of that night. He didn't reach, so the wajib upon him. You fast all Ramadan, a few minutes before last day, you died. That means you died in Ramadan, not in Eid. So it's not wajib upon you if zakat fitr. لأنه مات قبل وجود السبب. He died before it became compulsory. Okay, here nikah. ولو عقد الإنسان على امرأة. If a person marries, yeah, do nikah upon a woman. قبل الغروب, before sunset, من آخر يوم رمضان. لزيمة فطرها is واجب upon you to pay زكاة الفطر. على قول كثير من أهل العلم as a scholar. لأنها كانت زوجته because she is your wife when it comes فرض upon her to pay zakat al-fitr. فانعقد له بعد غروب الشمس. If the nikah happened after sunset, لم تلزمه, it's not wajib upon you to pay zakat al-fitr. So in here, let's see the summary. الخلاصة. أولا, وجوب زكاة الفطر. واجبة زكاة الفطر is واجب. قوت البلد, the food or the provision of the that place or that city the people use. And if you need in the weight, it will be 2 kilos and 40 grams minimum, up to 3 kilos. لا نقد, not cash. So it's better to pay 3 kilos. Or 5 kilos, once a year you are paid. You need Allah to give you everything. And at the end of the day, you need Allah to give you paradise. Very valuable. So pay easily. You see some masjids. That masjid is £4 with zakat. Next masjid wants more money. You say, oh, £3. And when you say, oh, £2.50, we will say, oh, £2.50 is easier to pay. When you're paying sadaqah, zakah, try to pay something good. Aqiqah, or udhiyah, they put on the TV. Yeah. In that country, £65, in that country, £50, in that country, £7, oh, £7, I'm paying this. Allah give you something, pay something. Go to 65 and make it 70 even. Yeah. That is, yeah. When we want Allah to help you and give you something. Number two, وقت وجوبها بعد غروب الشمس. As sunset is wajib upon you. تجب على المساكين واجب to give to the miskins. But who should pay zakah? تجب على نفسك ومن تملك قوته. Whoever lives in your house and you sustain, it's wajib upon you to pay the zakah. But your brother, your sister, or your daddy lives in your house, you can pay from them. It's wajib upon you to pay from them. But you can't pay from them. But who is living in your house, compulsory for you to pay. A man divorces his wife. How far she should wait before she marries? Yes, who knows? Three times to cut a period, not only months. So while she's in that iddah, if there comes a night of Eid, it's compulsory for you to pay her zakah. Because it's compulsory for the husband to feed the wife in her iddah. Accommodation and sustain. Still compulsory, as she is his wife. So the jiba al rajul al mutallaqati dalqat al raj'iyyah. Ma damat fil iddah while she is in the iddah. When it is said talaq, as soon as said talaq happen, it cut off, no raj'ah. So she's not compulsory for you accommodation and sustain her. In that case, it's not compulsory for you to pay her zakat al fitr. على نفسها she should pay upon herself. من أسلم قبل غروب الشمس whoever accepts Islam before sunset, yeah. ومن ولد قبل غروب الشمس and whoever born before sunset, they should pay it. It's compulsory for them to pay. Zakat al-Fitr is not wajib upon the person who passed away before sunset. Or he didn't reach the time. من ولد بعد الغروب أو ever born after the sunset. لا تجب على الزوج إذا عقد بعد الغروب. If the nikah happened after sunset, it's not wajib. Upon the husband. It's upon the wife to be الحمل, the pregnancy. The pregnancy didn't born, no wajib. But scholars, some scholars say base they can't count to you. But it's not wajib upon that. That's what we want to say about this issue. والله تعالى أعلم وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. We'll take questions إن شاء الله.